¿Cómo estás, Timmy?
What does that mean?
I don't know.
Let's go watch this feature on world language phrases.
Most students throughout Eisenhower take 3 years of world language. Students have a choice of Spanish, Italian, or French. They learn about the language, the culture, and much more. Part of the class is learning about different phrases. My favorite is "Ay Dios mío," which means "Oh my gosh" in Spanish. Thanks, Mr. C. Let's go see what Eisenhower's favorite phrases are.
So how are you, Jess, Matt, and Jess? So what language do you guys take?
French.
And what is your favorite phrase in French?
1, 2, 3.
Ça suffit.
And what does that mean?
It means be quiet.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So Ms. Burns, what is your favorite world language phrase?
My Spanish teacher used to say, mi tía tocar la guitarra.
Thank you. So Connor, what language do you take?
I take Spanish.
What is your favorite world language phrase?
¿Cómo estás?
And what does that mean?
It means, how are you?
Thank you.
So Sam, what language do you take?
Spanish.
And what is your favorite phrase?
Puedo ir al baño.
And what does that mean?
Go to the bathroom. I use it a lot.
Thank you. So Connor, what language do you take?
The piece of language, Italian.
And what is your favorite phrase?
Arrivederci.
And what does that mean?
Bye.
Thank you.
In conclusion, the teachers have done a great job teaching their students many different phrases. Keep learning, Eisenhower.
So, Kevin, what's your worst fear?
Let's go watch this feature on worst fears.
All of us have our fears, whether it's bugs, sharks, or being buried alive. We want to know your worst fears. Let's get scary. What's your worst fear?
Wow. Probably not having enough money to live on. Oh, and I'm retiring, and I won't have as much money as I do now that I'm working, and oh, now I'm afraid again. Maybe I better go tell them in the office that I need to keep my job. Excuse me.
So, what's your worst fear?
Being approached by an ETV interviewer and having no idea what to say.
So, what's your worst fear?
I could imagine nothing worse than McDonald's running out of sweet and sour sauce.
So, what's your worst fear?
My worst fear is someone taking Mr. Cuddles, my little penguin. He's so cute, right? He's just like the cutest thing. And I bought him at Boston, and he's like, oh, fluffy. And he's the cutest. I know, I love him.
What's your worst fear?
I have lots of fears. I think my greatest fear is heights. I'm really scared of escalators in the mall and stuff. It takes me a while to kind of go up them. I'm scared of getting my feet caught. I'm scared of going up too high. I'm also scared of the dark. Things jumping out at me. Yep.
What's your worst fear?
Well, I've never been stung by a bee, so my biggest fear is like me being in the middle of nowhere with like no like telephone, no cell phone service, and getting stung by a bee and then finding out that I'm allergic and I have no, you know, way to get any medical treatment.
So what's your worst fear?
My worst fear would be the Clash of Clans server going down.
So what's your worst fear?
Furbies?
Being kidnapped by Santa Claus?
So what's your worst fear?
I'd have to say my sister harassing me because it really hurts.
Oh, we're on it, we're on it, we're on it. So Ben, what do you think about the ETV features?
They're pretty good, but it takes a lot of work to make them.
Yeah, they do. Let's go watch this feature on what not to do during an ETV feature.
Hey Eisenhower, if you've had ETV, Hey Eisenhower, if you've had ETV yet, then you know it takes a lot of work to make a great ETV feature.
However, there are some things you need to check for while making your ETV features. Let's go take a look.
Also, when making an ETV feature, you have to make sure that your interviewer is smack in the middle of the camera. Am I in the middle?
Okay.
It's also important not to forget your lines because, in the script.
So, Kevin, what's your favorite food in the cafeteria?
My favorite food,
My favorite food would have to be like chicken nuggets. And
okay.
Hi.
Oh, are you busy?
One of the most important things to do when making your ETV feature is double check and make sure that you've edited everything perfectly. Okay, that was good. I think we could probably...
As you can see, there's a lot of work that goes... As you can see, there's a lot of work that goes into making a great ETV feature. Stay classy, Eisenhower. Whoa, hey, whoa, whoa, what are you doing? What are you doing?
The past few weeks, 8th grade social studies classes have been working on the Civil War project. We quickly realized that many officers had some pretty eccentric facial hair by today's standards.
The project was to research a Civil War officer and create a commercial that included a biography and reasons why they deserve the best title, the title of the best Civil War facial hair.
8th graders have worked hard to create original projects and win the competition. Ms. Tuff Canty, Ms. Katrajman, and Mr. Donald picked the top three commercials that will air next.
Now, it's up to the students and staff of Eisenhower to choose who truly had the best Civil War facial hair. The best part is that Mr. Wardo Samito has agreed to shave his beard on Thursday like the officer who wins the title.
8th graders will be collecting votes today, tomorrow, and tomorrow during tie time, lunches, and after school in the Team 1 hallway. You will also be given a lollipop if you choose to give $1 donation to a military organization in honor and memory of Captain Jason Jones with your vote.
A special thank you to Mr. Wardo Samito. Here are the top three Civil War projects.
And the nominees for Best Beard are General Grant, General McClellan, and General Mahone. The first nominee is General McClellan. He was created by Keenan, Charlie, Jack, Jimmy, and Sam.
You know you're a Civil War general, Foxy. And you know you're a strong bearded veteran, Foxy. I wanna go to war, yeah. You will lead with the power. Your stash has got to be all mine, Foxy mustache. Foxy, now I see you come down to the base, Foxy, you make me wanna get up and fight, I can't believe it now, you've made up your plan. You're ending the war in 10 months' time. Your stash has got to be all mine, Foxy mustache.
And the second nominee is General Grant.
In Point Pleasant, Ohio, born and raised, in the schoolhouse where I spent some of my days, learned all the stuff that would let me know how to win the battle, lead the country as a whole. I joined the Mexican War when I was 24. Soon enough, I was leading the Civil War. The beard came along and it showed my strong. Believe me, presidency wasn't easy. I served my terms and helped us day after day. 8 years went by, it was time to be on my way. They put me on the 50 to remember my beard. I died in 1855, being feared.
If you want to show support to Ulysses, call this number and receive your free beard. A $50 value, yours for free. Call now.
We the people of the U.S. grant this beard.
And the final nominee is General Mahone.
There are beards that reach down to your toes, and beards that grow right up your nose. They're quite impressive, I suppose, but I think I love your beard the most. Well, some are big and some are small, and some men don't have one at all. My grandma had one, I recall, but ladies' beards aren't beautiful. Well, just the sight of a beard can cure a frown. Just leave me feeling down. Oh, if your beard was mine to kiss, I just don't think I could resist. Lately, that's all I've been dreaming of. Oh, all great men who've been revered have facial hair. I only love you for your beard. There are beards that reach down to your toes, and beards that grow right up your nose. They're quite impressive, I suppose, but I think I love your beard the most. Well, some are big and some are small, and some men don't have one at all. My grandma.
Mr. W will shave his beard to match the winning general.
Get out and vote.